Hello, welcome to the MSP430i20 Sigma-Delta ADC demo. In this video, we will demonstrate how to use an MSP430i20x41 MCU to capture ADC data in real time and how adjusting various ADC settings will impact the ADC data. This demo will use a graphical user interface, or GUI, to display ADC data streaming from the MCU and to adjust the gain and preload settings for both ADCs, also called channels. For this demo, the MCU will function as a discrete ADC, sending data to a host. However, you can always reprogram the MCU to capture and process ADC data similar to an application-specific IC, and even perform other housekeeping tasks, increasing overall flexibility. Let's take a look at the hardware needed for this demo. Depending on your application, you will need the target board or the evaluation board to run the example code. The MSP FET is used to program the MCU with the example code. After programming, you will need a TTL to USB serial converter for enabling UART communication between the MCU and the GUI. Serial converters like this can handle the fast data transfer rate of 921.600 baud, unlike the MSP FET's backchannel UART. A function generator is recommended for applying known signals to the target board. The evaluation board includes onboard voltage and current sensors for submetering applications. Let's discuss the system overview, including the hardware connections. This demo will use the target board. The A0.0 positive and A0.0 negative pins are used to measure an input signal from a sensor or a function generator. Also, the A1.0 positive and A1.0 negative pins are used to measure another input signal. The inputs can be single-ended or differential. Soldering the included headers to the target board may simplify your connections. The UCA0 interface is used to communicate with the host GUI. This example specifically uses pins P1.2 and P1.3 for the UART communication. Make sure the TX and RX connections are correct between the MCU and the serial converter. The MCU can be powered by the MSP FET or by an external bench supply. Refer to the MSP430 Hardware Tools User's Guide to learn more. Finally, if you're using the evaluation board, refer to the schematic in the EVM's User's Guide to learn more about where to make these connections. Now, let's get started with the demo. Start by opening the GUI and connecting the serial converter to the target board. If you are using the MSP430i20x41, you can program the MCU using the GUI. Otherwise, you will need to program your MCU using Code Composer Studio. Overall, the GUI includes three sections. The first section cannot be changed but displays what clock settings are used to configure the ADC to sample at 4 kHz. The second section allows you to adjust the gain and preload settings for both ADC channels. After each change, both ADCs are stopped and then restarted to implement the change. Preload is the fractional sample delay between channels, so doing this helps synchronize the delay between them. The third section is the graph of the real-time ADC measurements. The fast UART data rate enables the ADC samples from both channels to be sent from the MCU to the GUI in between the ADC samples. In the GUI Composer project, under the scalar graph properties, you can resize the graph if necessary by increasing the buffer size for signals with slower frequencies or decreasing the min and max values for signals with smaller amplitudes and then rerun the GUI. Thanks for watching. Go ahead and try out the GUI yourself and check out the code example. We hope you enjoyed this video and come back to learn more about MSP training topics. Have a great day.